Greetings, welcome back to Pyre. Let us continue our journey. For the liberation. You make landing on the sacred Mount Alodia, upon whose summit the next liberation rite shall soon take place. You wonder whom you may regain his or her freedom this time. Wolfred finds you after the post-flight inspection. We shall have to take the rest of the trip to Fall of Solion by land. May we soon liberate another of our own there. That should raise the chances that our plan shall ultimately succeed. You call for me, Lovivita? Certainly. Who shall be the target of my wrath then, would you say? You ask Sandra to administer one of her special trials for Pomifan. Oh, you mean that feisty harp? She may yet be taught some manners, I should think. I shall attempt to bring her down to size, let us bring her forth. Soon Pomifa arrives in feet of someone. You call for me, Lugali? Oh, it's that crystal. Then let's hush it out and ready. Operation Sandra appears and unfastens her mask. Listen well, Harp, you answered to me here. You are bossing me, sure then. Go and tell me more. Such a delightful student for a change. Come then, let us see what you can do. Left to your own devices, save for your speedruns, of course. Let's show her what she wants to see then, with the darling.
Yeah!
There now, is everybody happy? Oh, happy as can be, my dad was pretty hard up. So good of you to ask. And about that, your performance was sufficient and you passed my test. With my congratulations both to you and to your lovely reader. Now, be gone from here before I have my second class. My, but Sandra sure could use a massage or something. So angry, isn't she? Say, what does you have there, darling? You see Trista's plum. Seek. Seek the Harpscribe's favor. Later that day, you accompany Hedwig into the fading glory of Emperor's Ascent, where a monument to Triester awaits you. Perhaps due to the nature of this place, you begin to sense Hedwig's inner thoughts, as clear as if he were speaking aloud. We have to prevail. Whether on my behalf or not, I do not care right now. We have to prevail for everyone's sake. Please, help us do it. Help us. Soon you and he are finished paying your respects. You return to the wagon in silence, feeling as though Tristathus has shown you favor. At dawn you shall begin your ascent. For now, the solitude here is fit for pursuing your vocations. Heaven gain plus. Yes. You and Pamitha go over what you know of the celestial landmarks you have been to, and how their properties impact the Night Queens in the Interite. You can tell she knows many of them well by now. I spent my life among the mountains. These places all felt very new to me at first. You find Hedwig rather lost in thought about something. He looks over as you approach. Oh, hey, my friend. Alright, so what's it going to be? He points in the direction of his cooking things strewn over in the corner of the wagon. Also, a very small comfort around here is with the thing that the day goes by that I'm not that grateful for it, but there's only so much to choose from. Whether here in Mount Alodia or anywhere around, I guess. Anyway, I was just having trouble trying to decide what to cook. Just had fire caps again last night, and those never seem to sit that well with everyone anyway. There's no more globio, not that anyone but Tiso ever liked that stuff, and I feel like we've been having gutter caps every day for months, so I'm not too excited about that. This is where you come in, and no consulting books or stars or anything. Just you and me. Here and now, what am I making? You decide? Because I can. I know there's a lot of serious stuff to think about these days, but... So help me. No one's struggling to regain their freedom on an empty stomach. You ask that Hedwig prepare another batch of his sealed porridge for the group. He eyes you worry as you place this setting for you for any trace of irony. Alright, my friend. Never thank you for the silk porridge diet, but so be it. I guess even after all this time, we still have much to learn about each other. Now, lend me a hand here with the stuff, would you? As you assist Hedwig preparing the silk porridge, the two of you get to talking about their past. The reality of cooking in the downside has a way of making him start it. Life on the blood border wasn't that much easier than trying to get by down here. The hiring remnants would swoop in at any time. They were so good at picking the worst possible occasion for us. The time they showed up and I was nowhere to be found, I must have told the authorities. On the contrary, had seldom revealed much about his past to you.
The American.
Well, either way, I don't think I ever told you much about Hikari. I was riding to relay an order when she caught me out in the open. She could have had me, but we just stood there, you know? I've never seen anything like her and her voice. She says to me, you ought to be more careful with your life. And I just say, I'm not the type to say such things, but it's all I could think of. Looking at her then, so I just tell her, it was for the days. Anyway, she spared my life, of course. And when we saw riders heading towards us, I look at her. She took hold of me and we just took off. I didn't want to leave her and I didn't for a while. Which was off for a while. Soon after I came back, I went off in search of her again. This time though, the risk I took, a lot of people paid for it. The harps attacked when no one was there to raise the alarm. A few days later, Hedwin the deserter was sentenced to exile. And now, he's about to cook some sealed porridge. Thanks for your help, my friend. I can take it from here. See you shortly. He heads out into the afternoon. You sense he feels more at ease after having spoken with you. Hedwin gained hope. On the way to the summit, he passed a monument to Under King Ores, and Silgimel happens to take notice. You wish for good fortune in the coming right and in your plan. As for Silgimel, if this night Gulloid has gone by, he often wonders. Perhaps you know the answer to that. Please do not spoil it for him. He says little after paying his respects. However, as you prepare to continue your ascent, you sense that Under King Ores has shown you favor. You and your companions gather once more at the Scribe's Gate, where a single narrow trail leads upward toward the summit, past an archway carved of stone. Come this way, please. The Mistral leads you toward the archway, where his current attack awaits. The exiles of the Night Twins have returned. They have. Greetings, Celeste. She all but ignores him and motions to the rest of you. Now then, each of you, in turn, please state your name and what is it that you seek whilst crossing the Scribe's Gate. Please do just as she says. Everyone steps forward, one after another, not like before. They pass through the gate. Hedwin passes through the gate. Thistle passes through the gate. Wookie passes through the gate. Tamitha passes through the gate. Sir Gilman passes through the gate. Wolfred passes through the gate. No one is left to go but you. You step forth and declare yourself as you did before. The Guardian of Scribe's Gate regards you with a still expression. Then she addresses all of you in her formal manner. The Eight Scribes bid the Night Winds welcome. Go forth with glory. The Lone Mistral glances up at the Gate Guardian.
Salutium,
you have a gratitude, Celeste. But she pays him no heed. Again, you gain the top of Mount Alodial, from which the downside sprawls before you. You wonder whether one among you soon shall follow Jodaria from this place. The Fall of Solian. From the top of Mount Alodial, the downside may be seen in its entirety, or at least felt since so much of the land is shrouded. but that is hardly all. Through a wondrous miracle, there lies upon this highest mountain an invented fall, whose waters crash not toward the sea, but rush toward the heavens. We speculate these are the very waters which delivered us, but now bend backwards, seeking their return, as do we all. In this phenomenon can freedom be achieved, but only for the chosen when the time is right. This is a path of to freedom we cannot traverse, but shall leave open for you so that you may try for it. Solid show. A sparkly thing in its center is, in fact, its heart, which it airs out from time to time. Okay, guys, you know it's great. It gets real awful. Go up here sometimes waiting for customers. So come on in, okay? And good luck in the big battle thing you got. That's where you're going, isn't it? I heard it's gonna be exciting from my friend. Thanks, guys! Good luck in that thing you're going to tonight. The time has come for your second liberation rite to commence. You observe the lone minstrel and Wulfred speaking in hushed tones, but cannot sense the topic of the older tone. Then Wulfred looks up at you. I trust that you are feeling as prepared as possible, my girl. Each rite is consequential to a journey in its own respect. Though these liberation rites have a more immediate effect. It's somewhat crass. However, I've gone and estimated by how much each of our companions may contribute to the outcome of our plan. They be liberated here. Factors such as their previous occupation, innate tendency to lead, and oratory skills contributed to my assessment. It's nothing personal, for we are all in this together. Besides, we all ought to return in time, if possible. No, simply that, for each one of us who goes, in doing so, he or she will rise all total chances of success. Either, madam, this night you shall confront the withdrawal. They have already appointed Ultmila to be liberated, should they manage to prevail. We all have faith in you, my girl. And what? Even the stars agree on this account. Beast Sunny Breeze. Not at this rate.
The Nightwings have returned unto the fall of Solium, at which the scribes first formed their sacred union. At stake this night is freedom and prosperity. But only for one exile who prevails in this liberation rite. Your many adversaries all did strive to earn this opportunity. Was the withdrawn which earned it? Who shall be absolved is up to all of you.
Voluntad, Lorgas. the pyres burn, and each of the triumvirates is present and prepared. I concur. The pyres burn, and each of the triumvirates is present and prepared. Then, anointed one of the withdrawn, go forth now and declare yourself, and pay any respects you have unto your adversaries, the Nightwings. The Vogdor Udmiolde appears from the shadows and reaches Lohamas. We are not the Witch of Milde. Our adversaries are nothing to us, or the Wizard. Here I shall be devoured in the coming age, in an age of strife, brought down by the thrill rings and vanishing eyes of Ishtar, the Astral Devil. You speak blasphemy upon the sacred site, Ulmilde. If you value your liberty, then I suggest you cease your mocking of the scribes. The scribes, they failed to stop Ishtar, and he shall rise again. As for ye, Nightwings, ye are of no consequence in Ishtar's grand design. She dons her mask once more. So, we shall return to the land which Ishtar shall usurp, where we shall offer him our beloved and that of many, many others. Now, then, if the Nightwings reach the decision on whose behalf they shall conduct the liberation rite, leader, I am bound to tell you once more. The first companion whom you chose shall go free this very night, if you prevail. Only the enlightened may be thus anointed, but all among you may yet be ready. The other two chosen for the triumvirate shall render aid. Nightwings, make your decision.
Who would you set free?
So, I'm to get my shot over at all this then. How very thoughtful of you, Vida Bali.
Who shall strive for her? Ruki.
Don't have to ask me twice. Not after everything Bam and I've been through. Tizo seems very determined to support Panisha.
It is done.
So, Ishtar, very soon we shall release thee. We shall release thee, and as for thee, my twins, we have much in store for thee. Invoke thee, for we seek thy ancient strength. Before our enemies within thy blood, damnation to the Nightwings, Damnation describes the invocation of Ishrach. Your adversary, which all the mirror curse shall summon forth dark pools of vanishing ichor. Where souls and the enemy exile is vanished, here is night.
Too bad for that one. Tito doused them high. Someone prevail already. There. And there it is, at last. The Nightwings proved their worth. Of their adversaries, the same cannot be said. Thus ends the liberation rite. And thus, the scribes have chosen. The exile appointed by the Nightwings shall be free. Absolved of all misdeeds. Return to glory in the Commonwealth. Her adversary and all others shall remain to carry out their rightful sentences.
Know that this suffering against Ishla has been recorded, and his vengeance shall down in the sky. So, wasn't I supposed to give a speech or something then? Later down, all of you. I've no idea what's still worried with me. Well, I do have one, but I don't think it's right. If we'd wanted to get rid of him by now, we needn't have gone to such lengths. And so, I'm not only to conclude that you did this for me. Three years I spent down here. In one sense, they could all be such ways, just utterly for nothing, spectacular, so I thought that my relationship was done if I had nowhere left to go but that, but, well, you know, not quite the case. But then, I think I'm not sure it would have become of me, had I made more attempt to see such things like, had I not done everything I had, I could not have lived with that, I think. I was so certain that my life would end down here, and only now beginning to consider that the opposite might have gone true instead. What I'm trying to say is, yes, to all of you, I mean that. Now, I guess I better head back on back to the damn Commonwealth. So, bottoms up! She plunges in the waters of the Shimmer Pool and disappears from view, though her voice still rings out. We'll have to see what we can do up there, provided that my sisters haven't had the way we did just yet. Anyway, let's find a way to keep in touch, but just in case, goodbye. Come if I am back for freedom.
Godspeed, Hamathathane. The eight scribes are ever merciful. By their grace, the cycle of the rites may soon commence again.
Accept that this.
And he may say, oh, good thing they wasn't even gonna amount to anything. not that they ever said anything like that about me, as of now, I'm very well regarded where I'm from, by everyone, in fact.
May the scribes have mercy on us all.
He returned to the wagon after having prevailed against the withdrawal and the liberation right. Not too shabby, people. He was pleased that Panifa is finally free. It succeeded in liberation Panifa. We return to the Commonwealth in glory. We did what we could with each liberation ride, we strive to advance our plan. A brighter future awaits at the end of our path. For now, we must persevere. Speaking of which, reader, I take it you have seen the stars, or I should say, the lack thereof. You have, or did. Once more, the sky is all abyssal darkness following the liberation ride. No stars illuminate themselves to guide you further on the path. Then let us go once more to Moonlight Alcove. I have an errand and a swan. Besides, once we arrive, best we cover now and make our way southward at first light. The withdrawn did spawn forth from the wild witch Milite, in whose vigilant pursuit of the unknown and the unknownable I always felt a certain kinship. Whether the withdrawn were Milite's kin by blood or merely worshippers, which was at one another not to ask or care. What mattered was that Milite chose the most audacious minds who stopped at nothing short of the impossible. Though ever distant, the withdrawn revealed to us such truths about the land which long lay hidden, even to one such as I. There are no knowledge ever waking into newfound depths of consciousness, they lead us all to better know ourselves. On mercy. Mercy is the beating heart of a truly free society. Mercy. Even for the perpetrators of the darkest deeds. As our leash Soldier Moor drifted in an ocean of regret, he found their mercy, or rather, it found him. And it saves his life. Mercy, freedom, they are intertwined. A society which raises a clenched fist against its own shall follow the doomed path of the Empire of Tsar. Ours shall be a merciful society. May the perpetrators of the darkest deeds be sent to join us here, where they may learn as we have. Mercy shall again engender a union among all our different kind. We shall stand shoulder to shoulder, equals in the same society. Typically, Rocky would be fast asleep by this late hour, yet he's wide awake now, although staring off at the unseen. You startle him somehow. I don't know. Being weird or something here, I guess. We got her out. We got her out. We sent her packing and all that. She shouldn't have had to be stuck here forever, and now she ain't. But, well, those are, I get some things for the girl. You understand? So don't complain anyone I said. As I'll bat you right in the hand, I swear. He looks at you in a sheepish way. Look, sister, I know I ain't her type. It just, we all got these stupid feelings and we're stuck with them, and that's just how it is. She's got plenty of her own, I bet. Once in a while, feelings like that happen to be shared, but it's all just a roll of the dice. A girl like that, she won't think twice about all the green tail once she's back there. Sitting pretty on the sun tower there, or something. He sighed, staring into the distance. I just hope they let her fly again, you know? It just I never met anyone like her as well. Never even really had the guts to let her know.
Okay, Sam.
Oh well. That's how it goes sometimes. I just hope that she gets an okay is all. And this is gonna sound pretty stupid here, but then who cares? It's stupid, but I'm thinking that if I ever get out of here myself, like, I'm gonna track her down. And well, that's about as far as I figured out, sister. Anyway, thanks for the and for making sure we beat those Swiftron bozos. And now, with Pam back home, I bet the plan of ours is in the bag. Maybe she can finally get her family stuff sorted while she's at it too. Now then, I'm beat. Good night. He hurries off before he can respond to anything he said. You sense, however, that some small burden has been lifted from him now. As for Pamitha, you hold out hope that she will find her way there in the Commonwealth somehow. And that's it for now. Thank you. Bye bye.